Hi, welcome to the Teacher's Playbook. My name is Melanie Howell. I've been a classroom teacher for more than 20 years. I started this channel because I wanted to start a new teaching team, a new kind of teaching team, a global teaching team. I figure we all have our favorite lessons, our top tips and hacks for being a classroom teacher. Why not create a place where we could all share our best information? Wouldn't children everywhere benefit from such a thing? Today's video is about homework. If you work in a school that expects you to give some kind of homework, then of course you're expected to hold kids accountable for it. And it can be very frustrating when they don't do their homework. Do I get frustrated? Yes. Do I get aggravated? Yes. Do I get mad? Yes. However, I have learned over the years that the best thing for me to do is not show anger to students over homework. Remembering that I teach fifth grade, so they're 10 and 11 years old, I have found that so many of them do not abstractly really understand how homework affects their overall average. So many of them think grades either come from me or just kind of drop down out of the sky and clunk them on the head. Or some of them, of course, are super obsessed with grades and it's all about grades all the time. And they're so afraid that if you're mad, psychologically, it kind of worries them and hurts them if you show anger over homework. I have just found that coming at a child from a place of, I noticed you didn't do your homework. Was it too hard or did you just run out of time? Don't just say, why didn't you do it? Because then they're having to come up with, should I tell the truth? It's easier to give them choices. Was it too difficult or did you just run out of time? Or did you just forget? I'm not mad, I just need you to tell me. Because if you need help, I'll help you. Honestly, I don't show anger over homework because I need to save my, oh, she's really mad, she's using her angry face and her angry voice over bigger offenses than homework. Now wait, if you're thinking, but you're a teacher and you're supposed to help them be successful and to be successful they have to get all the grades, yes, that's true. But I have found over the years that if I come at homework from a place of, I'm trying to help you get a good grade because you are earning the grade, I'm not giving you the grade, I have more success than if I come at you with a, I need you to do your homework because I'm trying to bend your will to make you do the homework for me. I need to make sure that the long-term goal is always first in my mind. And the long-term goal is to help them understand why doing homework is so important. And a lot of kids just respond in a better way when they know the logic behind your decision. Now, sure, you know, I'm an older teacher. I know that sometimes you shouldn't have to explain the logic behind everything. But when it comes to homework, I have found that this strategy really works. Don't use your angry voice over homework. Instead, come at it from a, I'm trying to help you. I'm worried about your grade. You're constantly reminding the kids that it's the grade that's being affected. It's not me that's being affected. It's the grade that's being affected by not doing your homework. So how do I get their attention if they're not doing their homework? Well, that's a whole nother story. But I'll tell you this, one thing is that on open house night, and I tell the parents, and on the first day of school, I tell the kids, if you are checking your grades online and you have a zero, it is not because I taught something and then you missed every single question. Because if that's the case, we have a big problem and we have a much bigger problem. So it's more, I give the zero because I need them to know, I need parents to know, and I need the child to know, well, this means something's wrong. And most of the time it means you didn't turn it in. So luckily, I work at a school where most of the parents do check the grades, and kids are learning to care for their grades in the fifth grade. And so they will check their overall average, and they see that it's dropped, and they come to me and they're like, why did I get a zero? And they are assuming that I have done something wrong. When I'll say, oh, well, you know, you didn't turn that in. I don't have a paper with your name on it. Well, I turned it in. Well, I don't have a paper with your name on it, and I don't even have a paper with no name on it that I could show you. So go check your, you know, blah, 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 your book bag, your binder, your cubby, wherever it is. Go check, go check, go check. Now, sometimes they come to me with the paper at this point and go, oh, sorry. And then I'll say, you know what? I'll be happy to grade this and change your zero. And it's over. But if this happens several times, if they keep forgetting to turn things in, if there's nobody at home encouraging them to check grades and figure out why their average has dropped, well, I hate to say it, but that's when the responsibility really falls on me. I need to up my game. I need to up my relationship game with the kids that aren't doing the homework, because they don't feel like they have enough of a relationship with me to think, I need to do that assignment for Miss Howell or she'll be disappointed in me. Because if we have a connection, some kind of relationship, they usually do their homework for me. It's the relationship. I know so much of what I say always goes back to, you gotta stoke that fire. You gotta find out about them. You gotta, even if it's through, okay, you haven't done this assignment, you know, if it's really aggravating you and you get to a point of, well, you know what, today during recess, why don't you come sit with me and I'll help you. You know, I'll reteach it to you. It'll be fine. There were several kids that had questions about this. It's okay. You know, whatever the scenario might be, as soon as you say, come sit with me during lunch or come sit with me at recess and we're going to work this out, you don't have to sound mad. They get what you're doing. They get that they're going to miss their time because they haven't completed something that you assigned and you have never raised your voice. And that's the magic, is that eventually they will figure out, she pays attention to me. I have to do assignments for her. And hopefully this whole time you're, because I mean, you don't have relationships overnight. You have to slowly build them. And sometimes you discover who you need a relationship with, a stronger relationship with, because they're doing poorly. I mean, sometimes that's just the way it works in teaching. Never use your angry voice over stuff like homework. Save it for bigger offenses. If you like this video, I hope you will subscribe or thumbs up or bell notification so that you'll get the other video.